Hello friends, in this video we will discuss a problem which is related to kinematics. So in the question it is given that a ball is thrown upwards and it is observed to have a height y above the ground, and this height y is given as at minus bt square, where the values of a and b are given in the problem, and the horizontal displacement of the ball is x equals to 10t. So now with the help of this data we have to find in part a the initial speed of the ball. In part B, we have to find the value of acceleration of the ball as a function of time t. And in the remaining part of the problems, we have to find the average velocity of the ball between t equal to 0 and 1 second. And thereafter, we have to find the time that has elapsed before the ball returns to its initial height from where it was thrown. So in the question, it is given that the value of y is equals to at minus bt square. The value of a and b are already given in the problem. So with the help of this data set, I can write the value of y is equal to 10t minus 5t square. Similarly, the value of x that is mentioned in the problem is 10t. So now in order to find the velocity in y direction, I can simply differentiate this expression. Velocity in y direction will be equal to dy by dt. So this expression can be differentiated and written in the form as 10 minus 10t. So velocity along y direction will be equal to 10 minus 10t. Similarly, in order to find the component of velocity in x direction, vx can be written as dx by dt, which is equal to 10. Now we have to find the initial velocity. So for finding the initial velocity, that is velocity at time t equal to 0, if I substitute the value of time t equal to 0, we will get the value of initial velocity in y direction to be equal to 10. Since velocity in x direction is constant, so now I can find the initial velocity of the given particle will be equal to vx I cap plus vy j cap, that is it can be written as 10 I cap plus 10 j cap in the vector form. And if I have to find the magnitude of this velocity, the initial velocity will be equal to 10 root 2 in terms of magnitude. Similarly, we can find the value of acceleration along x and y direction. In order to find the value of acceleration, we have to differentiate this expression with respect to time. On differentiating this expression, we get the value of acceleration in y direction to be equal to minus 10, and the value of acceleration in x direction is equal to 0. Now for part C of the problem, we have to find the value of average velocity from 0 to 1 second. So for finding the value of average velocity, I can use the expression as average velocity will be equal to the total change in displacement upon time. And now this displacement can be found by substituting time t equal to 1 second in both the expressions, that is the expression for y as well as the expression for x. And substituting time t equal to 1 second, we will get the value of total displacement to be equal to 10 I cap plus 5 j cap. And since the time frame mentioned in the problem is 1 second, so this will be equal to the value of average velocity. Now for part D, we have to find the time when the particle again returns to its initial height. That is, the displacement of the particle along y direction should be 0. Since the value of y given in the problem was 10t minus 5t square, so equating this value to 0, we will get the value of time to be equal to 2 seconds. This is the time when the particle again returns back to the same position in y direction, that is same height along y direction.